Storm Shield Weather, certified most accurate.
Love that idea. Should be a lot colder, we know, by Christmas time. All right, right now, this just came out. Thunderstorm warning for east and southeastern Oklahoma till 5:30. And I say east and southeastern Oklahoma because it's many counties down there to the southeast with 60-mile-an-hour wind gusts. In fact, right now, you'll see that it includes the cities of Muldrow, Salisal, Stigler, Wilburton, the counties of Haskell, LaFleur, Pittsburgh, and Sequoia. That goes until 5:30 as these thunderstorms are racing off to the east and northeast at about 45 to 50 miles an hour. So they're going to be out of here by 7 o'clock. Meantime, there's the line as it moved through earlier today. And here's some video that our mobile meteorologist John Haverfield captured as he was chasing these thunderstorms. And you can see the wind driven heavy rainfall reducing visibility. In fact, John was chasing even a tornado warning. Let's go to him now for more on today's storms.
Hey, Brett. Yeah, we've been out in Chaser 2 all afternoon. Started off in the Bristow area. Saw a severe storm come right across I-44 and produce some heavy winds and also some heavy rain. It caused some flooding. And then we went down to Okemah, and that's where we intercepted a tornado-worn storm. We heard the tornado sirens go off. We were actually watching some circulation, but the thing about it was, and I've seen a lot of these type of storms, it was shrouded in rain, so the circulation was embedded within rain curtains. Very hard to see. We're actually in the parking lot of a Walmart and talked to the manager, and he said he got everybody to safety in time. And if there was a tornado, it was completely wrapped in rain. We then chased that storm off to the east of Okemah, and it weakened just a little bit, lost its circulation, became outflow dominant. But it's been a busy afternoon here in Chaser 2, and we're glad to see the thunderstorms finally moving off to the east of Oklahoma now.
All right, thanks to our mobile meteorologist John Haverfield in Okemah. That's what the circulation looked like when John was in Okemah. There's the outflow that he's talking about, how it became outflow dominant. You can follow those storms like we did today using the Storm Shield app. It's simple. You just download it at stormshieldapp.com. It'll give you all of the warnings. How about this? Behind the storm, double rainbows from David Ballou, our elite storm chaser at 58th and Garnett. Another one from Julie Crone at 55th and Mingo. And then Matt Party took this picture, double rainbow, while he was at work in Tulsa. And now from Union High School, a beautiful evening setting up from our Midtown camera. Great chance to take a sunset photo and send it to weatherpics@kgrh.com. 69 right now. Dew point, though, still muggy at 67 degrees. The cold front is still over western Kansas, but I don't think we're going to get much more than maybe a couple of showers here this evening. No more thunderstorms. It's 51 at Dodge City, and that is certainly going to play a big role in tomorrow's cool high. Only in the middle 60s, and then by Saturday morning, we're dropping into the lower 40s, so it's going to be very cool and could be even cooler here by Sunday morning. As for tonight, partly cloudy, winds will switch to the north at 5 to 10 miles an hour. Bartlesville, 42 tonight. McAllister at 51, Tahlequah around 46. During the day tomorrow, look for clear and damp conditions in the morning, thanks to the rain, of course. Bright, mild by the noon hour, and we're talking about a cool breeze and a fall classic with a high temp in Tulsa tomorrow, right around 66, Pryor 67, McAllister around 70 and 65 out in Stillwater. Then the 7-day forecast, Saturday morning all the way down to 40 degrees, 42 Saturday afternoon. Look at Sunday, 36. Some of us are going to have a light freeze, especially north and east of Tulsa. 60 Sunday afternoon. We're still in the upper 30s again. Monday morning, 64, 70 Tuesday briefly, because here comes another cold front with some gusty, blustery north winds, a 40% chance of rain next Wednesday, and a high of just 61, Brian.